In this tutorial, we'll be creating a script that will produce this animation with Python in Blender. You'll also be able to easily create new variations of this animation. To follow along, you'll need a copy of some setup code so we can dive right in. You'll find a link in the description under Start Code. And underneath that, you'll find a link to the code that we'll get at the end of this tutorial, just in case if you run into any problems while you're following along. Hi, my name is Victor Stepanov. I'm going to be guiding you through this tutorial. Let's open Blender and go into the scripting workspace. Click new right here and then paste in the code that I just showed you on the GitHub page. Now that you've pasted in that code, let's make sure to save this file. The code that we just copied and pasted just cleans the scene, sets up the camera and the light. Let's run the script right now, right here at the top. And you'll see that it removed everything from the scene. I'm gonna hit Control Space to go into full screen and just set up the sun. I'm gonna hit Control Space to go back. Let's start by adding a cube into the scene with Python. As usually in Blender, you can add a cube by hitting Shift A and then selecting cube, and that will add the cube into the scene. Down below right here, you could see the code that you can use to add that cube into the scene. I'm gonna just copy and paste it into our script. I'm gonna paste it right here into the function called GenCenterPiece, and I'll remove everything we don't need. All right, now if I hit run, it's just gonna add the cube. You don't really see it because the cube doesn't move and it just gets removed and placed into the same place. So I'm gonna hit G in the viewport, and then just move it here, and then I'm going to run the script again. So as you can see, I removed this cube and added a new one. I would like to set the size to be random each time we generate this cube, and I'm going to use the random uniform function. So instead of having this 2 right here, I'm going to write random uniform. I'm going to set the size from 1 to 3. And now, each time I run the script, we're going to get a slightly different size cube. I'm just going to hit run, and as you can see, we're getting different size cubes. Now let's add the wireframe modifier to the cube. When adding a wireframe modifier, you usually go into the modifiers tab right here, click modifier, then hit wireframe. As you can see, the wireframe was applied to the cube. We can also control the thickness right here. I'm just going to copy the code to add the modifier right here. So I'm going to take this and paste it right below, and also changing the thickness. I'll need to get the active object with the polling code. You can replace this part with the variable for the cube. All right, let's run this code. As you can see, the wireframe was applied to the cube, and every single time I'm running this, it's generating a new cube with a new size and applying the wireframe modifier to it. I want to set the wireframe thickness to a random value each time. I'll just copy this random uniform call right here and paste it. I'm going to set it to go from 0.03 to 0.1. Now I'm going to run the script again and show you how you can see the thickness changes every single time we run the script. Now let's start working on the rotation animation of this cube. First, need to modify the scripting workspace to have the timeline so we can see the animation. I'm going to pull right here at the bottom and open the timeline right here. Collapse this. All right, now we have our timeline. Let's start adding keyframes. I'm going to add the code first, and then I'm going to go over it with you. All right, with this code, we're just setting the first keyframe at the very beginning of our animation. I'm gonna run the script. And as you can see, we have our first keyframe added. Now let's add the last keyframe and set the rotation to 360 on the x-axis. Okay, let's run the script. As you can see, the script added two keyframes, one at the beginning and one at the end. I'm going to press space to start the animation. And as you can see, the cube is rotating along the x-axis. Now let's take a look at the code. First of all, we created a variable called frame and set it to 1, which is going to be setting the current frame. Next, we're setting the rotation of the cube on the x-axis to 0, so it's not rotated at all, right? Next, we're adding the keyframe for the rotation data and for the index 0. In this case, it means the x rotation. So y is going to be 1 and z is going to be 2. And we're setting where we want to add this keyframe, and we want to set it to the value of whatever is in the frame variable. Next, we're adding this value to the frame. Context is a dictionary that we set up during our scene setup, and we set the current frame count, which right now is 360. Let me show you where that is. So if I go up here and into the setup scene function, and we're doing all the setup scene, we're not going over this in this video, but it just sets up everything, including the camera, and cleans the scene. And right here, we're creating a context dictionary and setting the current frame. We're calculating the frame based on the FPS and the number of seconds in the loop. So we're calculating the frame count. And right here, we're just assigning. So now we're using this value to set the animation to the last frame. Let's go back here. And yeah, this is exactly where we're extracting this. In short, this is the same thing as doing this, right? But since we want to make it so if we change the amount of seconds in the loop, it's going to automatically update. So I'm just going to undo that. All right. As you notice that the animation slowly starts, it speeds up and then slows down at the very end. We don't want that. We want to have this in a linear form. So if you press T in the timeline and set the keyframes to linear, it's going to be constantly rotating at constant speed. And as you can see, it's going to hit, it's going to go to the very end of the animation and it's not going to stop. See, it's like seamless, right? We want that. So with Python, we're going to use our special helper function for that. Let's run it. And as you can see, I'm just going to skip over. And we're animating at a constant speed. I'm going to comment this out and then run the script again. And as you can see, without that, it starts slow and then speeds up. I'm going to remove this comment and run the script again. All right. If we multiply this by some number, we can make the cube spin faster. So if I multiply this by 2 and then run the script, as you can see, it's going to be going a bit faster. If I'm going to multiply this by 5, it's going to go even faster. I want to multiply this by a random value each time. I'm going to create a list and I'm going to select one of those elements from the list to multiply it against. You'll see in just a second. And now let's run this code. All right, So the idea here is we're creating a list with all these numbers, and with this random choice, we're going to choose a random value from this list right here that we're passing in. So every single time we run the script, we're going to apply a different value. A zero, for example, means that we're not going to be rotating at all. The values with the minus are going to make the cube spin in the opposite direction. So I'm going to start playing the animation by hitting space, and then I'm just going to continue to hit execute on the script, and you could see that the speed and direction changes each time I run the script. I'm going to hit pause. Now I would like to set the starting rotation to a random value. It's this value right here. Currently it's set to 0, and I would like to change that. I'm going to get the radiance right here. And instead of having 360 here, I'm going to use this random uniform function that we used before and go from minus 360 to plus 360. Now let's run the script. As you can see, we're starting with a random rotation on the x-axis each time we run the script. Before we continue, I would like to move all this animation code into a special function called animate object rotation. I'm going to select all this code and go up here. Since we're using context, I need to pass this in as a parameter and also the object. I'm just going to call it, instead of cube, just object to make it more general so we can reuse it maybe later. I'm going to use that to replace this object. All right, and if I run this code, we won't have an animation anymore. As you can see, there are no keyframes added. This is because I'm not calling this function, and let's go ahead and call it right underneath where we apply the wireframe modifier right here, and not forget replace this object with cube, because that's the variable that contains the reference to our object. Now I'm going to run it. And as you can see now, it's working as it was before we moved everything into a function. Okay, now I'm going to do the same animation for Y and Z. I'm just going to go up here to the animate object rotation and write a similar set of code for Y and Z. I'm going to update this to Y and this to Z, and set the index to 1 and this index to 2. So X is 0, Y is 1, and Z is 2. Do the same here for the final frame. And now let's run this code again. As you can see, now we have random rotations on X, Y, and Z. I'm going to press space to start the animation and just keep running the script. And as you can see, each time we get something new. Okay, I'm going to press space to pause it again. All right, now let's use our helper function to apply the material. So go right underneath animate object, and we have a special function called apply material, and we'll need to pass in the reference to the cube. And I'm going to hit Z hovering over the viewport and set rendered. As you can see, the object doesn't have a material. Now I'm going to run this code and it's going to apply material to it. As you can see, now a material getting applied. Right, now let's see how it looks from the camera's point of view. I'm going to hover over the viewport and hit 0 on the numpad. All right, this is what the camera is going to see. It's seeing the background. I want to change that. I want to add a plane and set a color to that plane. And we're going to do it right in the gen background function. To get the code for adding the plane, I'm just going to hover on over the viewport and press Shift A and then add plane. I'm going to change the size to something bigger right here and move it on the Z axis like -5. So now that should give us the code right here at the bottom in the info panel. It's going to copy that, paste it here, set the size to like 20 and remove this code right here. All right, let's run it. And as you can see now, it's adding the background plane right here. So I'm gonna press Control Space to get out of full screen again. And let's apply the color to this plane. I'm gonna just copy this line material and just get the active object code right here as well. Just paste that in and just call it object. And let's run it. As you can see, this now starts setting the color. Now let's add a for loop in the gen centerpiece function to add more cubes. I'm going to select this by holding shift and just selecting this and then hitting tab to indent. So all of this fits in under this for loop. I'm going to use a range that's going to go from 0 to 2. And this is just going to repeat 3 times. I'm going to run the script. And as you can see, now we have some cubes generating. I'm going to hit space and just continue to run the script. All right. Space again. If you're enjoying this video, make sure to give it a like. I'll really appreciate it. And as a final touch, you can add a loop right here in the main function to repeat the generation of the scene as many times as you like. With this code, it will generate the scene 3 times. The number of times you've put into the count variable right here, and it'll pass the number of the scene into the scene setup. Let's see what that does in the scene setup. So right here in the scene setup, it's going to use this variable that we're passing in, and it's going to save a video of this loop with loop and then the number of the iteration. So if you want to render the scene, you can uncomment this part right here and it will start rendering the scene every single time. So it'll generate, render, generate, and render however many times you put into this count. So you hit render right here, render animation. This call to this function does exactly that. So when you want to do that, just uncomment this and then run it. I hope you learned something new and enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.